B-Hobby, B-Hobby, you need to be making your way to stage at this time. B-Hobbies, you need to be making your way to stage at this time. Hot laps are next for you guys. From the comfort of your own home, as we get ready for your B-Hobby hot lap qualifying. Once again, attention to the pit area. American Pro Late Model Series. You're needed in staging at this.
Race fans, of course, Eric gave me the great introduction. Of course, my name is Walter Tapp, the voice of the American All-Star Series, co-voice of the Blue Ridge Outlaw Late Models, and the announcer for the GM Performance 602 Late Model Series, and owner of that series as well, plus the announcer at Travelers Rest Speedway down in South Carolina. Speaking of South Carolina drivers, actually from the state of North Carolina, but competes a whole lot in South Carolina, he'll be the first car to lead him to the green flag tonight. They call him the new ninja out of New North Carolina. That is Ricky Green. Behind him in the 73 machine, the bed store entry for the Stinger Race Cars. That is Trevor Sykes, the 2020 series champion in the 73, and he is hailing from Knoxville, Tennessee. In that beautiful 17J machine, working down the back straightaway, that is Matthew Jordan out of Lancaster, Kentucky, in that machine. In the 113, Chris McKinley behind the wheel of that 113 machine. He is also out of the great state of Tennessee. Behind him out of Georgia in a train chassis, Sylvan Chute in the 14 machine. And we're going to bring him to the green flag this time. Green out as we get rolling with a fast tab entry there for Sylvan Chute as he works down into turn number one. Stinger Race Cars, the bed store on that machine. Jack Frost heating and air for the 73 machine of Trevor Sykes as he now works down the back straightaway. Ricky Green in the 18 machine, the driver to Greenback, Tennessee, and a Rocket XR1 chassis. Tractor Supply on that machine. That is Tyler Price. Tyler Price now looking as he takes the white flag this time. The 17J out on the Speedway, the driver out of the great state of Kentucky, behind the wheel in that machine, Matthew Jordan. Matthew Jordan making his second start with the series here tonight. He had a start last night at Crossville. Oh, Chris McKinney around. Jordan, evasive action, hard on the binders, and the caution will fly. The racetrack starting to take rubber, starting to black over. You can see the black from top to bottom already taking place and rubbering up. But also, when you get out of that groove, it is very unforgiving, and you've seen what happens. You can easily slide that car around on the very dry, slick surface with that rubber taking place. Now, once it rubbers up, it will create great racing from top to bottom here this evening. And we will send our first group off the racetrack. Ricky Green and Trevor Sykes both putting up some great laps along with Sylvan Chute in the 14. Group number two going to roll out onto the Speedway out of Mooresville, North Carolina, the 31 machine. Fox on the side of his ride. That is the 31G of Steven Padula, the modified standout in that 31 machine. The driver out of Junction City, Kentucky, Logan Walls in the 14W working down the front straightaway. Great run last night. Travis Kern Racing Engines on that machine for the 9. Also out of the great state of Kentucky, that is Josh Dietz. Behind Josh Dietz in the 22 machine, R&W Properties. Dazzling detailing on that machine, CBR Race Cars. Morgan McClure, GMC, Chevy, and Buick, the points leader, signified by the yellow spoiler. And your winner last night at Crossville Speedway, Hayden Cardwell. Behind him, Bailey Cardwell in the 07 machine. In the 21 machine out of Knoxville, Tennessee, that is Trey Bain, brother to Xfinity star Trevor Bain and Daytona 500 winner. In the 89 machine, then that is a CBR Race Car entry. That is Brandon Miller, a former winner with the series at Mountain View Raceway and former Rookie of the Year contender. Awesome design concepts on that machine on the 89 for Brandon Miller. Green flag in the air, and we are underway with group number two. Rim riding around the bottom is the 22 machine of Hayden Cardwell, who knows his way around this racetrack. Josh Dietz getting a little bit squirrely. He'll get on the binders and gather it back up. White flag in the air this time. The 14 of Logan Walls. Going to take it down the front straightaway. Gaddy's forms on that machine. He's going to dive it off into turn number one. Right in the middle groove. Josh Dietz on the outside of Hayden Cardwell. Bailey Cardwell. Trey Bain into that 21 machine. Now we'll see if Trey's actually in that machine, because there was talks that Trey may be running just a tad bit late. And Ross White, a former American All-Star Series multi-time winner, could possibly be hot lapping that machine as well. Before, that was what we had talked about over there in the pit area. Bailey Cardwell in a 07 machine coming around. And here, rolling down the top of the hill, will be our third and our final group for the American All-Star Series presented by PPM Racing Products. And as it stands right now, Hayden Cardwell doing what he's been doing all season long with a 15.706 in hot laps over Trevor Seiss, Trey Baines, 21 machine, Stephen Padula, Ricky Green, Tyler Price, Brandon Miller, Bailey Cardwell, Sylvain Chute, and Josh Dietz, your top 10. But you know what they say, hot laps does not pay a dime, does not mean anything. They can go back over there, work on that car, and get ready to rock and roll. A driver in the 10B machine, who in April could have went to victory lane and swept the weekend. He had a car that was super strong, but the turn three tire took him out both nights. Can he make redemption here tonight? That is Bradley Llewellyn out of Seymour, Tennessee, in the B-Clean pressure washing CVR, down into turn number one and two. Behind him, that is going to be the 20 machine of Devin Stewart, the driver out of Blue Ridge, Georgia, where we're going to be making a trip to down to Sugar Creek Speedway in September on the 24th for a $10,000 to win show at Sugar Creek Speedway in Blue Ridge, Georgia. Working down into turn number one, the Oaks on the side of his ride. Also, that is a Savage Racing chassis. Competition racing equipment on that machine for the Boo crew. Josh Boo Henry out of Newport, Tennessee. Behind him in the 8 machine, that is the man known, the man, the myth, the legend, Chris Chandler himself out of Weaverville, North Carolina. The Weaverville Warrior, Chris Chandler, in a TNT race car entry. Green flag in the air. Bruce Built performance on the 9 machine. Jack Frost heating in the air. Zach Sykes behind the wheel. Golden Locks in a Stinger race car entry. Behind him in a Savage chassis out of Seymour, Tennessee in the 2P machine. Tar Chevrolet. That is Terry Poore in an Excel Racing chassis entry. William Blankenship in the 32 machine. Also out of the great state of Tennessee. 18 years old behind the wheel. And always fast here at I-75 is Blankenship. White flag being shown to the rest of the field. We'll be looking now for the checkered flag this time. Checkers in the air. Devin Stewart going to take the checkered flag. We'll see if anybody's able to shake things up out of this group in hot laps once we get everybody by. Still Hayden Cardwell atop the board. Trevor Seiss. William Blankenship out of this group now is third fastest with a 15.993. Then it is Trey Bain, Stephen Padula, Ricky Green, Tyler Price, Bradley Llewellyn, Zach Seiss, and Brandon Miller, your top 10. Race fans, is anybody riding with Hayden Cardwell here tonight in the 22? Can he put it in victory lane? Can Trevor Seiss put it in victory lane? Maybe William Blankenship. How about the youngster, Trey Bain? Fourth fastest there in hot laps. And like I said, we will look to see if there's confirmation on that, if Ross White was in that machine or if it was Trey Bain. Stephen Padula, Ricky Green, Tyler Price, Bradley Llewellyn, Zach Seiss, Brandon Miller, your top 10 here in hot laps. But as they say, hot laps does not pay a dime here this evening. Qualifying going to be coming up next. 602s, final call, front wheel drive, be ready to roll.
So here we go with your 602 late models. It's going to be the D2 of Darren Goins. Multi-time feature winner here at I-75. Then you got the 22 of Dustin Ward, Brendan Ward in the 7. Then the 5 going to be Curtis Thomas. Dante Curtis and Spencer Cranfield. Now that's going to be group number 1 as we're going to go green flag, give these guys a couple laps around I-75. So the checkered is going to come out on group number 1. We're fixing to roll down group number 2. As we need our front wheel drives, you need to be in staging as well. Front wheel drive, you need to be in staging, guys. So once again, if you know somebody at home that wasn't able to make it out, tell them they can catch all the action on Dirt 2 Media. Courtesy of Richard Ford Flipper, right here, multi-year videographer. We was actually watching a video from back from 2005 at the Tennessee Motor Speedway in Baxter, Tennessee, just before the racing got started. So here we go, we're going to go green on the 9. That's going to belong to Josh Cheatham. As we're going to give these guys a green white checkered here. As we need front wheel drive, you need to be in staging. Front wheel drive, you need to be in staging. So your third and final group of your 602 is going to roll down to the racing surface. As you're going to see the 25 of David Singleton and the 19 of Michael Courtney, both of those multi-time feature winners here at I-75. Front wheel drive, last call, front wheel drives, you need to be in staging at this time. B-Sportsman, you need to be in staging as well. B-Sportsman, we need you in staging. So that's going to conclude our 602 late model hot laps as we're going to roll into your front wheel drives. They are going to be up next for hot laps. So here we go. Front wheel drive, heat rate, hot laps. So group number one of your front wheel drive is going to come to an end. We're going to roll down to group number two as Allie with the American Pro Late Model Series thinks it's easy to be an announcer. As we're about to turn the mic over to her if she keeps on the way she's going tonight. Group number two rolling down the chute right now. B-Sportsman, you need to be in staging. B-Sportsman, you need to be in staging at this time. So you're going to see a couple of familiar faces out here. You got the 13 of Zachary Roderick. Then you've got the 21. He competed last night at Crossville Speedway. That is the 21 of Dawson Duncan. As we get ready to go green in group number two. So that'll do it for your front wheel drives. B-Sportsman, you need to be in staging. It is time for your hot laps. B-Sportsman, it is time for your hot laps. You need to be in staging, guys. American Pro Late Model Series drivers, you need to be in staging. It is time trials time. Racing for Christ time trials is going to be up after our B-Sportsman division.
Green flags now for B-Sportsman hot laps. Caution flag is out. The green flag is out. American Pro Late Model Series to staging. American Pro Late Model Series to staging. The green flag is out for the second group of B-Sportsman hot laps. Caution flag is out. Caution flag is out.